at 4.
Mama, calm down. Mama, calm down, okay? You're gonna die now. You die. And he starts killing them. And they're pleading in desperation. You can hear them plead. You can hear them being killed.
That chilling interview captured by News 2's Andy Cordan 2 years ago after one of Tennessee's most infamous crimes. 8 people brutally killed, 1 man charged. Welcome back to News 2 at 4. I'm Erica Francis.
I'm Eric Egan, and today marks 2 years since the Sumner County Slayings, one of the state's deadliest serial homicide cases. Today, the sole suspect here, Michael Cummins, awaiting trial, potentially the death penalty for those 8 killings. His mother, father, and uncle were among the victims found in their Westmoreland home April 27th, 2019. The crime scene has been described by investigators as one of the most gruesome they've ever seen. News 2's Stassi Olmos went back to the Sumner County community today, where many neighbors say they're still in just disbelief over what happened.
In overgrown brush and trees sits an empty mobile home where one of Tennessee's worst massacres took place 2 years ago.
It was crazy. SWAT was everywhere down here, going through every building we have on this property, which is a lot of buildings.
It was just hard to believe. I mean, you know, when you see somebody that night before, you know all of them, and then all of a sudden, everybody's gone.
A 911 call led police to 4 bodies in the home of 25-year-old Michael Cummins. His uncle, the uncle's girlfriend, her mother, and daughter, just 12 years old, were dead. Cummins' grandmother was seriously injured. They also found a 69-year-old woman down the street dead and her car stolen. The Westmoreland community went on lockdown.
We actually had neighbors coming to our home to ask if they could borrow a firearm.
Authorities found Cummins hiding in the creek with a hatchet that night.
Coming back from searching for dead bodies all day long on horseback.
This is Carolyn Chambers the morning after the murders, looking for more potential victims. The next day, investigators also found the bodies of Cummins' parents in the home as detectives continued to comb the crime scene. And in a stunning twist, nearly 2 weeks after the murders, officials linked Cummins to yet another death involving a man who was found decapitated 10 days before the mass killings.
The only thing that kept him from coming down here and taking a right to where we're at is these 2 dogs here, and he knew better than to come down this way. So he went over the hill and killed that lady that lived by herself.
The experience horrified residents. Some say they would still like to move. Others say they now bear arms.
I got guns now.
If it was your behind sitting out here in your house and you had a braving maniac going around butchering up people, I think you might learn to appreciate having that .38 sitting there in your lap rather than sitting there going, okay, he's coming in, what am I going to do?
At the time of the killings, Cummins was on probation for setting fire to a neighbor's home and assaulting her. He now faces the death penalty.
I do not believe that they should put him to death because at his age and the upbringing he had and the lack of direction he had in his life, I don't know what put him over the deep end. I know they grew up poor, real poor. I think he's mentally ill. He's too young. He needs to have that chance to turn his life around and give his life to the Lord and learn that there is good in this world, even though he may not get to experience it down here as a free man.
Reporting in Westmoreland, Stassi Olmos, News 2.
Michael Cummins is at the Riverbend Maximum Security Prison in Nashville. We're told he's not had many visitors. A jury trial is set to begin in April of next year.